A very good morning, students. In today's class, I'm talking about galvanic cell, the third part of it. Before we actually go on to the third part, we need to revamp what we actually know about the cell. The EMF calculation, this representation of the cell, oxidation always happens at the anode, and oxidation is your loss of electrons. Reduction always happens at the cathode, which is gain of electrons. And how do you get the standard reduction potential value, and how do you use these values to get the EMF calculation? Moving ahead, this is the table that we use to calculate the EMF value. This table gives us the values of the potential here, and this clearly shows addition of electrons, which is reduction. Reduction has the tendency of positive, means reduction happens. A negative value means reduction is resisted. So, if you are looking for an element to act as the cathode where reduction has to happen, you would look for those elements where reduction is happening, means one out of these. While for the ones where it should act as anode, should be the ones where reduction is resisted. So, the negative reduction potential values are the elements which you would choose to act as the anode. I have taken a simple example to move ahead. For a given galvanic cell, which is E0 value is nickel 2 positive with nickel is minus 0.25. Since the value is negative, it resists reduction, so should act as the anode. E0 for silver ion is given as positive, which means it prefers reduction. Therefore, this becomes your cathode. Hence, the anode would be your nickel and cathode would be your silver. Reaction at the anode. Reaction at anode is always oxidation. Oxidation is loss of electrons. Who would be losing electrons out of these two? Nickel, of course. So, nickel loses the electrons to become nickel 2 positive and 2 electrons. While reaction at the cathode, you have gain of electrons at cathode. So, out of these two, which will gain electrons? Silver ions having a positive charge. So, silver ions gain electrons to become silver. Why have I multiplied it by 2? Is 2 have no electrons in your final equation. So, you need to multiply the second equation by 2. Hence, you get a 2 here. Electrons get cancelled and your net reaction now becomes nickel plus 2 silver ions goes to nickel 2 positive ions plus you are left with 2 silvers. This becomes your net reaction. What is the value of N? N stands for the number of moles of electrons that are transferred from the anode, this is the number of electrons transferred. To the cathode, these are the number of electrons reached. So actually, we very well know, electrons move from the anode towards the cathode and we have got 2E, so the value is 2 moles of electrons transferred from the anode to the cathode. The cell representation. Talking of the cell representation, we begin with the anode, which is nickel. In contact with the nickel ions, I am taking it to be 1 molar because we are talking about a standard cell. Then you have a salt bridge. The salt bridge is in contact with the silver ions. Again, I am taking it to be 1 molar under standard set of conditions. Beyond this, we have the silver metal in the cell. So, this is how you represent your cell representation, taking the anode on the left and the cathode always on the right. Value of the EMF. To calculate the EMF value, the formula that we use is E0 right minus E0 left. Right means cathode. So the value is 0.80 minus E0 of the left, which is the left anodic side. The value is minus 0.25. This value ultimately becomes 0.80 plus 0.25. This is your final answer. Taking these two values, you end up in a 25 here. I add the two, your answer becomes 1.05 volts. That's a 1.05 volts is the answer for the EMF calculated of this particular step. Moving ahead. Now moving ahead, we have something called as the normal hydrogen electrode, which is also called as the standard hydrogen electrode. This is the construction of a standard hydrogen electrode. What does it have? It has a beaker containing dilute sulfuric acid. The concentration is 1 mole per liter. So you have 1 mg H positive ion concentration in the solution. You have a platinum wire. You have a hydrogen gas which is bubbling out. You have a platinum foil covered with porous platinum, your electrode. The reaction that happens in a normal hydrogen electrode is like this. The H positive of the cell combines with the electrons and becomes hydrogen. You can make it twice to balance it out. This reaction is happening in this particular cell if it is acting as the cathode. But in case it is acting as the anode, then the reaction becomes reversed. Hydrogen goes to 2 electrons, loses 2 electrons, NH plus. Which actually means this particular standard hydrogen electrode can act as a cathode as well as an anode. This is a absolute electrode, or it is an electrode constructed which is also known as a reference electrode, which helps us to find out the comparative values of reduction potentials of all the elements and that table that you saw. So in this case, if your NAT is acting as the cathode, you have this reaction, reduction, and if it is acting as the anode, you have this reaction, that is oxidation. Hence, your NAT can act as anode as well as the cathode, and which is dependent on what is it bound with. If your electrode that you are binding it with has got a higher tendency of oxidation, it would undergo oxidation, and for force of circumstances, your NAT will have to gain electrons and the reaction will go in the forward direction. But in case your NAT is bound to a metal which has a tendency of accepting electrons more than hydrogen, in that case, electrons will be pulled out from the hydrogen electrode and your hydrogen electrode will have to act as an anode. And when it is acting as an anode, the reaction that would happen is the reverse reaction. Moving further. This is how we go about it. Your cell is constructed in a way, you dip your metal into the salt solution of copper sulfate and you connect it to a NHE. This is your NHE with platinum dipped in an acid solution, a platinum wire, hydrogen gas. So your NHE is on this side and you have connected it to the copper. As you can see, the electron movement is from left to the right, which means this is acting as the cathode, your NAT is acting as the anode. If it is acting as the anode, since the electrons are moving from this end to that end, therefore it is understandable that it will undergo loss of electrons like this, where hydrogen is going to H plus and 2 electrons are being lost. While electrons are going towards the right hand side, where copper ion will gain the 2 electrons to become copper, become the reaction on both the ends. So your NAT is actually used to determine the value of standard electrode potential of any given element like this. In this construction, we can now find out the value of the standard EMF or the standard reduction potential of copper from the voltmeter readings, taking the value of E naught for hydrogen electrode to be 0. That is taking the value. It's not 0. No element can actually act as anode as well as cathode. It is a relative term. In this particular cell, copper has got a higher tendency to gain electrons. Therefore, this has to give electrons. So this acts as the anode. Moving to the next example. In this case, the NHA is bound to the zinc electrode. And you can see the electrons are moving from the zinc towards the NHE, and the value that we got was a minus. A minus shows that it is undergoing oxidation. If the zinc electrode has a higher tendency of oxidation in comparison to hydrogen, so electrons are moving towards this side. Since the electrons are moving towards this side, this electrode will have to gain the electrons. So this is acting as the cathode, and this will undergo reduction, which is gain of electrons, and this is exactly what is happening. Your H positive ions are gaining the two electrons to become hydrogen gas in this cell, whereas zinc is acting as the anode in this cell, and you can get the values from the voltmeter reading. Moving ahead, I'll take up a question to end my lecture. If you are given a reaction of a cell like this, according to this, magnesium is changing to Mg2 positive, which means if you go from magnesium to Mg2 positive, there is a loss of two electrons. Therefore, your anode is magnesium, which is undergoing a loss of electrons. Hence, automatically, cathode becomes hydrogen. Reaction at the anode. At the anode, you always have oxidation. So, your magnesium would transform into Mg2 plus, plus two electrons. That is the anodic reaction. At the cathode, you have reduction. The reduction would happen for H. H would gain electrons and become H2. Since you have two electrons in the first equation, the second equation also should have two electrons to get the net reaction. So you multiply by two all over. Cancelling out the electrons, your net reaction here becomes, I'll take the net reaction on this set. The net reaction therefore becomes magnesium in contact with 2H positive, giving you hydrogen gas. It won't be twice here. You would have an H2 here. And you would have Mg2 positive. When you multiply it by twice, this won't be there. So you should have, you should not have this. Fine. So your reaction becomes, this is your net reaction in the cell. The value of N moles, the electrons transfers was 2, so the value of N is 2. Cell representation. Talking about the cell representation, you have magnesium in contact with magnesium ions, salt bridge, in contact with H positive ions, 1 molar, which is in contact with hydrogen gas, and which is in contact with platinum. A hydrogen electrode is taken like this. Calculate the standard EMF of the cell and identify whether the galvanic cell is working or not. To calculate the EMF of the cell, the values would be cathode minus anode. Cathode minus anode, your cathode is hydrogen, so 0.0 minus. If you look up the table for magnesium,